As with any of my designs, I like to utilize raised panels at the ends of the finished piece. Now, there is a problem here because the raised panel system has a stub tenon incorporated in the design, and it's only 3/8 in width, and it's extremely weak, as you can see here. So with the finished product, this is a structural area, the two ends are structural, and you want to avoid racking. So what I intend doing here is installing 3 3/8 dowels on all four corners. These can be 1.5 inches or two, probably better to be the 2-inch long dowels. These will be blind, they won't be seen, and it will make this system extremely rigid. Now, the first thing we do here is we install an 1/8 inch spacer. This will put us in the centre of the stub tenon. And we're also going to reference from the front face. So this is the front face here. This is the checks or numbers. I've got the number 2 here and the number 2 on there. Additionally, we want the 3 dowels to be in the centre. So you can use this, our own distance gauge here, but I've made up a little distance gauge, a small one, which will do all four corners so we know that everything will be identical. Another thing to note here is that the length of all the rails and the rails and stiles are identical, so we can actually move from the upper section down and from the lower section up. So now we'll place this one. And tighten your clamp screws evenly, because you'll get a bit of sway there. And then we're going to drill 2, 3, and 4. That's that one finished. See, we're fairly close to the centre of the stub tenon. And now we take the rail. Now the number 2 is here, number 2 is there, so we reverse this, make sure everything's tight. Now with this one we have, you recognise there's a mortise here for the stub tenon, so the mortise is, the depth is 3/8, so we have to go to a longer drill setting by an additional 3/8 of an inch. Take care when you hit this part, it doesn't tend to bite, so just take it easy on that part. And that's it, complete. We're now going to dry fit the raised panel assembly, and as I said before, when you're dry fitting something, never use all the dowels. I'm going to in this particular case, but don't use all the dowels, just use 50% or so, because if that works, it will all work. If you install them all, you may not get it apart again. So this is number 2 here, so we'll install the center panel. And number 2 to 2. as you can see, this is a really nice, neat, very accurate assembly. So this is number four. That's all installed. Now, number three, finished assembly, and it's absolutely rigid, and once that's glued and clamped, that will never fail.